Several weeks ago, we published the teardown of the Baseus 30W Adaman 2 power bank, and today we got another Baseus 65W power bank of the Adaman series. Its overall design is almost the same compared to Baseus 30W power bank, but the capacity reaches to 20,000 mAh. Let's go ahead and check what's inside. Like the 30W power bank, all specs info in different languages are printed on the back. Tear off the sealing strip on both sides and open the box. It contains a cable, the power bank, and some documents. This is a short dual USB-C cable with Baseus logo, suitable for power bank. Take it out from the plastic bag. The blue matte metal case can reduce fingerprints, and the digital display is in the upper right corner, which shows the charging info. A big 65W is in the lower left corner. The power button is on one side, and the Baseus logo is on the other side. Compared with 30W power bank, it adds a micro USB port and maintains one USB-C and two USB-A ports. The specs info of each port is under them. The rest of the specs info are printed on the button, but list PPADM65-S. The USB-C port can support up to 60W input and 65W output. Both USB-A ports can support up to 30W. It also passed CE, FCC, UKCA certifications. The size of this power bank is about 153x65x26.5mm. It's about the same size as the iPhone 14 Pro Max, but much thicker. And the weight is about 454 grams. Connect ChargeLight Power ZKM00TC to the power bank, and it shows the USB-C port supports FCP, SCP, AFC, QC 3.0, PD 3.0, PPS, QC5, Apple 2.4A, and Samsung 5V 2A protocols. And it also supports 5 fixed videos of 5V, 3A, 9V, 3A, 12V, 3A, 15V, 3A, and 20V, 3.25A, and 2 sets of PPS. As for the USB-A1 port, it supports FCP, SCP, AFC, QC 3.0, Apple 2.4A, and Samsung 5V 2A protocols. And the compatible protocols of the USB-A2 are exactly the same as the USB-A1. Next, let's go ahead and take it apart. As usual, use the spudger to pry along the gap and remove the button cover. We can take out the internal module from the button. The battery pack is sealed with a blue plastic cover, and a foam is pasted in the front for buffer. The entire module is fixed inside the plastic frame for protection. Remove the upper cover. The PCBA module is fixed by screws. Unscrew all the screws. We can see two blue thermal pads on the back of the PCB for heat dissipation. Cut off the black and red wires. Take out the battery pack. The battery pack is attached to the plastic frame with double-sided tape. There is also a piece of foam at the bottom, and the tabs of battery pack are insulated with poly paper and heat-resistant tape. Tear off the blue plastic cover and take out the battery. The size of each cell is 100x60x5.5mm, and 4 cells are connected in series, 3.7 volts, 5000 mAh. This is the battery protection board under the poly paper, and the battery tabs go through these holes and connect to the board. The battery protection chip is from CellWise CW1244, which can support 3 to 4 cells connected in series and has a variety of protection functions. Those two battery protection MOSFETs are from Allepic Semi and adopt DFN 5x6 package, with send voltage at 30 volts. This is a 3 milliohm sampling resistor for overcurrent protection. Then let's move to this main PCB. An LED segment display in the upper right corner shows the charging info. It is fixed with foam at the bottom. The primary controller, two sets of synchronous buck boost MOSFETs, and two V-bus MOSFETs are on the back of the PCB. The primary controller is from Silan and is compatible with various fast charging protocols. It can support the fast charging of up to 4 USB ports and 2 USB-C ports, and it is suitable for 2 to 7 cells. Two sets of synchronous buck boost MOSFETs are the same. all four MOSFETs are marked with 7446. Those two inductors on the left and right are insulated with a heat shrinkable tube. It's used for buck boosting of USB-A and USB-C ports, respectively. These two hybrid capacitors for USB-A and USB-C outputs are from BERYL TA series, 100 microfarad, 25 volts. Press this power button to check the charging and battery info. As you can see, all four USB connectors are orange, while the internal contacts of two USB-A connectors have been widened for higher current charging. Well, that's all components of this Baseus 65W power bank from the Adaman series. After taking it apart, we found that the internal structure is quite similar to the more expensive Baseus 100W power bank from the Blade series, but it's more like 30W power bank in appearance. So you can choose 30W, 65W, and 100W according to your personal needs. Okay, that's all for today's video. You can click the corners to check the teardown of Baseus 65W and 100W power banks. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you next time. Bye!